Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Here are some strange things in macOS that are actually pretty useful. MacMost is brought to you thanks to a great group of more than 1,000 supporters. Go to MacMost.com/Patreon. There you can read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. So there are some features of macOS that are really strange, but they actually do have some uses. Let's start off looking at Finder windows. So if you switch a Finder window to icon view, this only works in icon view, you could actually set a background color or image. Go to View and Show View Options or Command J. And at the bottom you'll see Background and you could set it to a color and then choose any solid color you want, or you could set it to a picture and then drag and drop an image in and it will set it as the background picture. I could see the color part being actually useful in maybe giving you a hint as to which folder you're looking at, but it only works in icon view. It would be useful if it actually showed that color somehow in list and column view as well. Now at the top right hand corner of your Mac screen you'll see the time, but you can also have your Mac speak the time every 15, 30, or 60 minutes. So go into System Preferences and from there go to Dock and Menu Bar. Then scroll down until you see Clock. Then there's Announce the Time. Select that and you can select on the hour, half hour, or quarter hour and select which voice. And then you'll get a spoken time. And this could actually be really useful to help you keep track of time during the workday, maybe to encourage you to take breaks every once in a while. Now if you select text and copy it, of course you've placed it in the clipboard. But what if you don't remember what's in the clipboard? Well, one way to find out is actually go to the Finder, which is an odd place to have this because you'd think you'd be able to see that, say, here in TextEdit or in Pages or whatever you're using to edit text. But switching to the Finder, where you manage your files and folders, is where you could actually view it by going to the Edit menu and then there's Show Clipboard. And it brings up this little resizable window showing you exactly what's in the clipboard. It works well with text. It works with some other types of media as well, but not all kinds of media. Now macOS is built on top of a version of the Unix operating system and there's a lot of stuff hidden in the system that's just left there when macOS is built. If you go to Folder and you select /usr/share/calendar, you're going to end up in a folder that shows all of these calendars. They're actually just text files with lists of holidays. So for instance, I could select this one. If I control click it and choose open with, I can open it with TextEdit and you could see an easily readable list of US holidays. Now it could be useful to look at other holidays from other countries, but there's also a couple of weird things in there. Like for instance, this gives you a list of events that happen in the Lord of the Rings trilogy. Now macOS has a built-in summarize feature where you can select text, say in an article like this. Let's control click on it and under services, you should see something called Summarize. Bring that up and it shows that text in this little window. Then you could drag this to have it shorten the text, including what it thinks are the most important parts. Of course, it's just using an algorithm to figure that out, so it may or may not be accurate. But if you're faced with reading a 10-page document in less than a minute before a meeting, it could be worth giving a try instead of just giving up. If you don't see that feature, go into System Preferences, then Keyboard, and then Shortcuts. Look under Services and find under Text the Summarize option there and make sure it's checked. Now the music app has a weird feature called the Visualizer that's been around since the early days of iTunes. Basically if you're playing some music you can go to Window and then Visualizer and you can choose actually here between two different types, the original and an updated version that came out years later. The Visualizer looks like this. You can make it full screen if you want by clicking there. You can also use Shift and question mark to bring up help and then you can see there's some keyboard commands to change what you see. This could be useful if your Mac is playing music but you're not using it for anything else. Like if you have your iMac in the corner of a room and you're having friends over and you're listening to music. But you could also screen record this and then take the recording and use it as an animated background in iMovie. Now you can select some text in almost any app. Go to Edit, Speech, Start Speaking and it will speak the text.
An American inventor and businessman.
But you could also change the voice that's used. If you go to System Preferences and then to Accessibility, Spoken Content, you can change the voice that's used. An odd thing in Big Sur is you get Siri voices listed here, but they don't work in speak text. So it's going to default to one of these. But there are also some really odd ones. You can get the odd ones by going to Customize. And then if you scroll down, you'll see Novelty Voices. So I've selected three here and it downloaded them and added them. These voices have been around since before macOS 10. So if I were to change, say, to this one and then have it speak text, that's what I get. They are really strange and were probably just used for demonstration purposes in the early days of text-to-speech. But now you might actually find some use for them if you have trouble concentrating on what's being spoken and you want to kind of switch it up and have it read to you in a weird voice that you have to pay a little more attention to. So of course you know you can use the Preview app to open images and PDFs. But if you put Preview in the dock or just have the icon somewhere available, you can drag other file types to it as well. So for instance, you could drag an application to Preview. So what happens when you do that? So let's drag the calculator app into Preview and it will open it up and give you access to the icons embedded in the app. With some apps, it'll give you even more than that. If you drag iMovie into it, it's not only going to give you the icons, but it'll give you all sorts of other graphics that are part of the iMovie app. And while we're here in the Applications folder, there's an app called Photo Booth that's been around for a while and was used to demonstrate the webcams when they first started appearing as part of Macs. Now you could still use it to actually capture images from your webcam. It only works with the built-in webcams like on MacBooks and iMacs. But you can take pictures, you can do a quick recording, and you can use filters as well. It's fun to play with, but it's also very useful if you need a quick picture of yourself or you want to record something really quick to send to somebody. Okay, so here's probably the weirdest one, but maybe the most useful of them all. Let's say you want to sort a folder by the duration of a video or maybe the dimensions of a photo. If you click here in the column headings when you're in list view, that's where you can sort, and control clicking will allow you to change which columns are present. But you can see there's no duration or dimensions here. However, if I were to go to the movies folder and then control click here, I do have duration for videos. And under pictures, I do have dimensions. How do I get those extra columns anywhere but the movies and pictures folder? Well, all you need to do is rename a folder, movies or pictures, to get them. So let's go into example files here. And let's say I want to get those special columns. I can go and change the name of the folder temporarily from example files to movies. Now when I go into list view, control click, I get those extra items. So let's add duration. And you can see I've got duration out. There's only two videos in this folder, so I just see those two duration times. Now here's the cool thing. I could go back and change the name of this folder and it still remembers the duration column. So it sticks with this folder until I remove it and close the window. So I've got duration. I could also go and change the name to pictures, then go to list view, add dimensions. Now I can see I've got a column for that. Let's go and change the folder name back to example files. And now you can see I've got both duration and dimensions and I could sort by either one. Even if I change to another view and go back to list view, it remembers. Even if I close the window and open it again, I can go in and you can see it still remembers those. So I permanently added those columns in list view to this example files folder using this special trick. So as you can see with macOS, it's not always what you see is what you get. There are some weird features built in and sometimes they could be quite useful.
If you like this video, click the thumbs up button below to let me know. I publish new tutorials each weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out.